Hi, Chris Malouf with XCountry Mortgage here. Inflation has been in the news quite a bit lately. And have you ever wondered, how does inflation affect my mortgage payment, or how does inflation affect the real estate market? Today, we're going to go through three ways that home ownership or property ownership hedges against inflation. So stick around. First of all, let's start out with this. What is inflation, okay? Per Webster's Dictionary, inflation is a continuing rise in the general price level, usually attributed to an increase in the volume of money and credit relative to available goods and services. Now, what does that mean in layman's terms? What that means is, as the price of things go up during an inflationary period, groceries, fuel, whatever it is, the purchasing power of your dollar goes down. That means you can't purchase as much as you could with that dollar before an inflationary period. Now, what is causing inflationary period? The Federal Reserve has been pumping a lot of money into the economy since the outbreak of the coronavirus to keep the economy afloat. When you start increasing the supply of money, the economy starts to run hot, as they say, and eventually you're going to run into some inflationary pressures, which is what we've seen. And that's why the Federal Reserve is starting to taper back on the amount of money that they're putting into the economy. Now, how does real estate hedge against inflation? Well, number one, if you lock in a low fixed rate on a mortgage payment, that mortgage payment does not fluctuate with inflation. It stays consistent. And historically speaking, as inflation goes up, so do interest rates. Okay, so you want to lock in a low rate so that that payment does not fluctuate over time. Number two, you're not exposed to rising rents. The inflationary tide raises all boats. So as the price of groceries and fuel and everything else goes up, so do rents. I've never heard of a landlord reducing rent. I've only heard of landlords increasing rent, right? And then number three, property values, historically speaking, have gone up over time. That means real estate is what's called an appreciating asset. The value of that property, the value of that home, historically speaking, has gone up over time. So parking your money in an appreciating asset during an inflationary period is a good thing. Now, this is not earth-shattering stuff, okay? This is not a lightning bolt from the sky. Per an article in Forbes Advisor in February 2021, private investors are taking advantage of cheap money. In the first quarter of 2021, investors bought one of every seven U.S. homes purchased. What that means is investors are taking advantage of low interest rates and putting it into real estate, which again is an appreciating asset. If you're new to the home buying process, feel free to reach out with any questions. We're happy to help. They simply do not teach a lot of financial literacy in the school system, so we try and bridge that gap. We'd be happy to answer any questions, and we'd love to help you get into your own home. Have a good day.